Okay, welcome back students. Let us continue now. So have you understood that how the two person have settled the matters and maintained the supremacy of Maratha in the northern side and in the southern side? So remember their names also, Mahaji Shinde in north and Nana Phadnavis with the help of many other Sardars in the south. Then the Holkers of Indore, Bhosles of Nagpur, Shindes of Gwalior, Gaikwads of Vadodara brought glory to the Maratha power on the basis of their valor, leadership qualities and capability. Yes or no? So in this lesson we have studied that the all the names, yes, Holkers, Bhosles, Gaikwads, Shindes, all these have brought a change in the Maratha power. They have established our Maratha power through their valor, through their bravery, through their leadership qualities and all the capabilities they have, what a Sardar or a Peshwa should have. So with their qualities they have brought a glory to the Maratha power, and they were the pillars of the Maratha power in its last phase. So where there was a last phase going on, okay, that time these all people proved to be the pillar. You know, pillar means what? Strong pillars without which a building can't stand or any construction can't stand. Yes or no? So that way these all people proved to be the pillars of the Maratha power. Okay? The Maratha Sardars were successful in establishing the influence of the Maratha power both in North and South India. We have seen this, yes or no? Both in the North and South of India, we have became success in establishing or influencing our Maratha power. That means we expanded Maratha power in both North and South of India. After the death of Mahaji Shinde, turn your page. After the death of Mahaji Shinde and Nana Phadnavis, the Maratha power began to wane. So now the bad phase of our India started. Now you will see that how much we have gained, that much we started diminishing. Whatever was we have gained, that was slowly diminishing. Wane means what? Going on declining, going on decreasing. So our power now started, or you know, went on decreasing or diminishing day by day soon after the death of Mahaji Shinde and Nana Phadnavis. Okay, so at that time Bajirao II, the son of Raghunath Rao, was the Peshwa. Now which rule was then? Mahaji Shinde died, so who was the Peshwa now? Who was the Peshwa? Raghunath Rao's son Bajirao II. Okay, he did not have leadership qualities and had many vices. So this Bajirao II, though he was the Peshwa, but for the Peshwa, for that person, he should have all the qualities because he is looking after the administration of the country, yes or no? But he was not having any qualities. In fact, he was having many vices. Now, what do you mean by vices? Means wrongdoing. He was a person who used to do many wrong things, okay? So he was doing many wrong things. He was unable to unite the Maratha Sardars. He was himself not having all the capabilities and potentials, and you know, he was not that much having all the leadership qualities. So because of that, he could not unite the Maratha Sardars. The internal strife between the Sardars weakened their power. So whatever internal strife, whatever you know, disputes or conflicts were there inside the Marathas, because if the leader is not good, then will the people or the followers will be in a good condition? No. If leader is good or strict, then everything will be in a disciplined way. So leader was not having good qualities, and that's why everything was becoming, or you know, it was a very bad phase that the Maratha's power was weakening day by day. During the reign means what? Rule. During the reign of Bajirao II, the Maratha influence in the north and south waned further. So again, we have established such a great power in north and south, but during his rule, during the rule of Bajirao II, the power of the Maratha started waning further. Waning means what? Decreasing further. The British replaced the Maratha. So now our power was weakened, and whose power was more? British. And the Britishers replaced our Maratha. So now whose power came into existence? Britishers. Okay. The British captured Pune in 1817 CE and hoisted their flag, Union Jack, there. So see, Britishers captured our Pune area in the year 1817 and they hoisted their flag named as Union Jack there. Then in the next year in 1818 CE, the British defeated Marathas in the Battle of Ashti in Solapur district, and finally the Maratha power came to an end. So Britishers, even they defeated the Marathas in the year 1818 CE, at which place? In the Battle of Ashti in Solapur district, and this way our Maratha power came to an end. Okay, so it was really a very bad phase we were going through at that time. So this event marks a major change in the history of India. So isn't it a, because up till now, till previous lessons also we have studied that so much efforts our Sardars had taken to establish the Maratha power in almost all over the country, and now everything was lost. Okay. After this, the British managed to gain control over a major part of India. So now Britishers are the ruling, so that they managed to take or conquer or get their control over the major parts of India. So India on a whole became the slaver or the gulam of the Britishers. Yes or no? So this way, Britishers started to gain control over the major part of India. India came into contact with the Western world. That led to many changes in India's social system. Then afterwards, India was coming in contact with the Western world, with the other countries, okay? And then some types of transformation started happening in the social system of India. So then many old things became redundant or were pushed aside. What do you mean by redundant? I mean unnecessary, which is no longer of any use, okay? So many things were unnecessary, they were of no use. So they were all pushed aside. The things which are not important, which are not necessary, they were pushed aside. This was a major transformation. So though we were under, the Britishers had controlled us, but slowly, slowly, India started changing. India started a transformation. What things were not necessary were put aside, and they were trying to maintain relations with the Western world so that they, with their help, with their power, we can again bring a change in our system. So this way, a major change took place. The medieval period of Indian history came to an end. So what that phase we were having when we were under the control of Britishers, that was the medieval period, that was coming to an end, and the modern period began. Okay, after that the modern period began, the changes in the transformation and changes took place in the history of India. So with this we finish our lesson. Hope you might have understood. Thank you. Take care.